Welcome to Irish Football Fan TV. This is the breaking news that Daniel Crowley has decided to declare for Ireland from England. Currently playing at Willem II in the Dutch Eredivisie at the moment. A real exciting prospect for ourselves. I mean, you know, you look at Jack Byrne, who actually went there, played for Canberra, and had a real breakthrough season at the time. I know his career kind of went a little bit stale after that, but this is positive news. This guy's a creative midfielder, you know, has had real good performance against the bigger teams in the Dutch league as well. So, you know, the fact that he's coming out now in an article in the Independent today saying, you know, he cried his eyes out when we got beat by Spain in the 2002 World Cup, and saying that, you know, when he grew up, the only kit he ever wanted or played in was the Irish kit. Now, having represented both England and Ireland at underage levels, he has decided to declare for the Republic of Ireland. Arsene Wenger actually brought him to Arsenal as a youngster from Villa, he was 16. So he obviously thought very highly of him. So he seems to be rediscovering that form that ultimately got him to move there in the first place. But now he's playing in the Dutch league, as I said, but he's putting in some real stellar performances there for them. So, you know, Martin O'Neill and Roy Keane had actually invited him and his dad to meet in 2015 in Belfry Golf Club. But because at the time he was playing for Barnsley, and he was making a real he was making a real impact from Barnsley to them. So this. How he is actually connected with Ireland is, I think it's his grandparents, because in the article it says his dad's parents are from Waterford and Cork, and his mum has relations in Mayo. So that's the Irish link he has there. So, you know, he grew up in England, and he has friends and all there. But the team he supported in Euros 2016 was Ireland. This is a statement from himself in The Independent. It's written by John Fallon today, this morning. But he also came out and, you know, he said he made it aware, or he made it known to Mark O'Toole, the same guy who Declan Rice thanked in his statement, saying that, you know, he'd like to let it be known that he wishes to transfer for the Republic of Ireland. So he's hoping to process the transfer now, and he won't be eligible for next month's games against Gibraltar and Georgia, but he might be available in the summer if they get the transfer process quick enough. So ideally, you'd want to you know, get him in there for the summer. The more players we have declaring for us, the better. The more options we have, you know, it's a no-brainer really. So yeah, it's one of them where, you know, we have to kind of watch how this materializes in terms of his career, how he finishes up the season in the Dutch league, and, you know, where, if he decides to stay there, or if he goes there, if he gets a move to one of the bigger clubs in Holland from his performances, you never know. So, you know, he came out and said he's matured on and off the pitch since his time in England, because he had a bit of a bad time, I suppose, before he left. So, I mean, it's great that he's starting to put these types of performances in and getting noticed. So that's been the breaking news. He's decided to declare for Ireland. So it's the opposite of Declan Rice, basically. So, yeah, just pretty happy now that he's decided to do that. So I just thought I'd break the news to you guys, to anyone who didn't know. And one more thing, if you haven't subscribed, please do so now, because we are aiming for 5k, and we're working really hard to produce videos like this constantly, and, you know, consistently. So all you gotta do is click that little button just down below. So if you wouldn't mind clicking it, that would be fantastic. And we'll speak to you all soon. Thanks for watching, as always. Come on, you boys in green.